Hello and welcome to FlutterFlow Expert Training. My name is Majid Hajian and I will be your trainer for this training. I want to kick us off by sharing why behind FlutterFlow and what makes it unique and differentiated from other app development tools out there. And I was thinking, who could explain this better than co-founder and CEO of FlutterFlow, Abel Mengistu? Abel, could you share your vision and mission behind FlutterFlow?
Yes, thanks, Majid. So at FlutterFlow, you know, our goal, our mission is to help the world build great products. And I think a good question here is, you know, why do we even, so this is the reason we exist. And, you know, are we needed? Like, why is this necessary? And I think the way we look at it there is we look at a lot of products that, you know, we use ourselves daily, that we know, you know, our friends use our networks. And in fact, it's a journey that we went through ourselves too, of trying to build an app for our last startup. And we found that bringing your ideas and your vision to life is not happening at the pace and the quality that people really want it to. And so, you know, whether think of any, you know, whether it's like large airline applications or even to banking applications to a lot of businesses around the world. I mean, if you think about just in the last 5 to 10 years, there have been over 1 billion people that have come online around the world. And how many of those, you know, users have applications that are relevant in their communities, where they are, for the businesses that want to provide services for them? So we just saw an opportunity to help empower a lot of developers and builders out there to bring their visions to life. So that's our mission. And in terms of what the product is as an abstraction level, you know, in this industry, we've kind of over time moved to higher and higher level abstraction. On one end of the spectrum is machine code. On the other is things that just kind of give you a template out of the box on some kind of extreme no code tools. And where we feel like is the magic is having a visual interface to help you build your applications while you still have access to that source code and ability to customize it and really empower you to move really quickly. So that's kind of where we place ourselves in this dimension. And so we see FlutterFlow as a visual development platform. So we see it as an iteration in the tradition of development platforms. Now, our core value proposition is, like I said, an easy to use visual interface, because when you're building visual applications that have visual interfaces, we believe a visual medium is a great way to quickly see what you're doing in real time and iterate while you still have access to control and ownership of your code. So that's something that's, you know, when we started FlutterFlow, that was non-negotiable. We if you don't own your code, if you don't own your software, then you don't really own your application. And so we believe that was a, you know, something that is essential. And of course, the other side of it, I think that people don't necessarily always realize, is that when you have this visual interface, all of a sudden it unlocks collaboration across different stakeholders on a team. Now imagine how many teams you've seen where, whether it's the executive or the product manager or the designer, may not be able to kind of go in and change something. Maybe it's a simple text in your mobile app, and it has to kind of go through a ticket system because it's somewhere in the source code and it's hard to navigate and it's not as transparent, it's opaque. Versus having a platform that allows different stakeholders to kind of come into the same tool and collaborate as if it's a Google Doc in real time, right? So that's one of the things that we really feel like is also going to really empower this cycle of innovation. And those are our core value propositions. Now, maybe I can kind of dive a little bit deeper into each section. So with the easy to use visual interface, this gives you an ability to edit visually with real time preview. So as you're changing things, you can kind of preview what is happening on the screen. In fact, I think Flutter, what kind of made Flutter very popular early on was this hot instant reload kind of feature, which is one way to kind of get there where you're changing the code. And if you have your emulator running, you can kind of see what's happening there. And what we're doing here is we're making that even more seamless by having the ability not only to interact with the code for this, but to actually interact with that real-time preview that you're building. There's a lot of out-of-the-box components and pre-built interactions that make it easy for you so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel. For example, if you need to show a dialogue that shows up, you don't have to, you know, you can just do it. It's, you want the dialogue to show up, and you can just say, yes, I, when this button is clicked, I want the dialogue. And we want people to think at that abstraction layer of that product interaction and not necessarily think, okay, now I need to remember exactly how to write this code and write how many other lines of code we would require to do that versus saying, this is exactly what I want to do. And this, you know, purpose-built user experience, common interactions, being able to be leveraged quickly. The next part is the seamless collaboration and deployment. This is a key kind of problem that I think plagues a lot of teams in general, is just the silos of having to do handoffs and wait kind of on implementations. Now what happens is you have a very linear process where before, you know, something can be done, you have to, you're waiting on the on your previous dependency who is working in a different tool and a different platform and has to kind of hand it off to you and communicate it to you in some way. And then you have to take that implemented. And there needs to be a change. Now you're going back all the way to the beginning versus if you could collaborate in the same platform, maybe you can start working on things in parallel, right? So you can come in and start, someone can start adding the API integrations at the same time as someone else who's adding some custom kind of code functionality while someone, the designer is on the front end designing the page and a front end engineer is connecting that and adding the logic. And so we think kind of streamlining and parallelizing the different efforts at the same time can really enable teams to move really quickly. And to add to that, rapid deployment, whether it's to the App Store or Play Store or to web, being able to quickly deploy without having to go through a lot of process of setup, et cetera, we think also is an advantage here. And finally, control and ownership of your code. We believe, you know, own your software, own your code is something that I think there's is a core purpose of FlutterFlow is to really empower. And one thing we've seen is we've seen a lot of enterprises, even startups, where potentially they get an application kind of built for them, but then ultimately they just get the binary and they don't have access to the source code, and that's limiting. And so we believe control and ownership over your code is important. Okay, cool. So that's in a nutshell what we're about for FlutterFlow, and we're very excited that you're going on this amazing journey of learning FlutterFlow with the awesome Majid. And thanks. Back to you, Majid.
Thanks, Abel. All right, let's review this course. In each module, we will start by going through the concepts and fundamentals. Then we will demonstrate how to use these concepts in a real application. Our approach is hands-on and interactive. The videos in each module will help you learn the theory and see it in action, as well as you will have quizzes and hands-on assessments. And don't worry, if you ever feel stuck, you'll find many resources attached to this course to explore further. So, let's get started.